I've done a lot of videos saying the lies that we tell our children, the lies we tell us why we can't be good investors. Today I'm doing a video, very rare for me to do, is the lies we tell ourselves when we are in debt and we don't want to come out of debt, or we are unable to come out of debt. What are the lies we tell ourselves? One amazing lie which I hear from younger people, not so much from the older people, is that debt is normal, right? So it's like saying, are you stressed? I'm stressed. But everybody is stressed, isn't it? Stress is normal. BP is normal. Sugar is normal. It's not normal. You have chosen that lifestyle. You've chosen a lifestyle because of which you have some lifestyle diseases which you are not making too great an attempt to get rid of it. And that is exactly how you with the debt. Don't be in denial. Debt is not normal. The problem is today too many videos, etc., come and tell you there is something called good debt and something called bad debt. So buying a house on loan is a good debt. Taking an educational loan is good debt, right? So some of these things, be very careful as to what people are telling you. Any kind of debt, whether it is a home mortgage, car mortgage, educational loan, is debt, and it increases cost. Understand the difference between a businessman taking debt, a Mukesh Ambani or an Adani taking debt. They take debt, whatever cost. Cost doesn't matter, because 5 years later, if I tell you 8%, it look like very low, or 5 years later it could sound very high. So it doesn't matter. Let's say they take borrow money at 8% or 9%. They know that they can use that money, create a product and charge 10, 11, 12%, whatever, and recover the cost. That is borrowing for investing. That is a very different type of an investment. So if you have to borrow money to buy a cow and you're selling the milk, it makes sense because it is creating income. Borrowing money to buy a sewing machine to stitch clothes for somebody creates an income, and you don't have money to buy the sewing machine. If you have money to buy the sewing machine, you should not borrow, right? So don't get into that denial mode that debt is okay. Everybody has debt. That's another stupid argument. Everybody has debt. That does not make it great. Everybody, I mean, 70-80% of cars sold in India are sold under debt. Why? Why can't you use your own money? Why can't you plan? Why can't you plan in 2021 about the car that you want to buy in 2024? Why can't you do a SIP in a debt fund for 3 years, maybe 10,000 a month, maybe 25,000 a month, depending on the car that you want, and use that money to buy a car, use that money to buy maybe a house. You will never be able to do that kind of an investing, so you borrow. But even there, I have a rule which says 3, 20, 30, 40 rule. So go and have a look at that, right? So that is the kind of amount. I don't think you should borrow more than 50% for the house. Buy a smaller house, that's fine. So right, so first of all, stop saying that debt is beneficial. Then the other person to be blamed here are the chartered accountants who tell you that taking a home loan is fine because it is tax deductible. For heaven's sake, it doesn't matter whether it is tax deductible. There is a limit also, and even after that, it is not a very sensible thing to do, of borrowing money just because you're getting a tax break. For heaven's sake, no businessman does that. Can you imagine going and telling Mukesh Ambani, pay me 1 rupee because anyway it is tax deductible for you? So any cost which is incurred in the business makes no sense. If it is avoidable, it is avoidable. But at least in a business, you know why you're borrowing. But borrowing to pay for expenses, I even don't like my cooperative society borrowing from the bank to spend money on the upkeep of the building. Does not make sense, because you don't have money, so you borrow money. That actually increases the cost of the construction, right? So borrowing for expenses is completely out, so don't do that. Thirdly, there are people who feel that money is very complicated. अरे ये तो बहुत complicated. I won't be able to understand how to repay the debt. So थोड़ा बहुत debt does not hurt me. I met a person who had borrowed money. He had a personal loan. He had taken a personal loan for doing some travel. Believe it or not, personal loan to do some travel. And he had mutual funds. And he had SIP going. And his logic was, oh, SIP returns are far greater than the personal loan returns. I was stunned. You invest because you have money. You don't invest because HDFC Bank has money. HDFC Bank will always have money. And whenever I try to do a transaction in the brokerage house where I have an account, it tells me, sir, you can borrow 6 times your portfolio value. Quite stunning. And I was quite surprised. So I checked out, it turned out to be maybe 60% of my portfolio value, not six times my portfolio value. But it constantly keeps offering me. Let's say I have a 10 crore portfolio and I go to do a 10,000 rupee transaction, it will still offer me credit because he knows that he's got recourse to my assets in case something goes wrong. So debt is thrown at you continuously. Just learn to ignore it. You don't need that debt. You don't need that second car, third car, or that more expensive phone or the more expensive watch or a watch plus phone combination, right? Be careful. Debt is very complicated, and there are just too many people wanting to lend to you, especially if your score is pretty high. If your score is even 800 plus, then they just want to lend to you. They love you. They know you will not go wrong with it. Maybe you will skip 1 month, and that's fantastic for them because they're going to recover more in charges, right? Then we tell ourselves, oh, I will never have enough money to pay off all the debt. I will always be in debt. What happens to your debt when you retire? You have to repay everything. So what happens is all your PF goes away into that. Then how do you live for the next 30, 40 years, right? So don't be into denial saying that, oh, my PF, I will adjust. No, you dare not adjust. Just PF alone is not sufficient for your retirement. So your retirement corpus takes a hit because of your borrowing, because when you borrow 1 rupee for a 20-year period, you end up paying 2 rupees, right? That is the kind of interest cost that you pay when you borrow. So be careful. Don't borrow. Home mortgage is the cheapest and that is expensive. So which means other loans like a car loan or a personal loan or a vacation loan, these are all just loans that they know that you will repay because you have a job. The minute you don't have a job, all of this has to be repaid, and if it gets repaid from your provident fund, your retirement corpus goes for a toss. Then there are others who believe that I want a product now. I just want it now. I have to replace my fridge now. I have to replace my washing machine now. I must have that vacation this week because my friends are going. Or have a group of friends who spend far more than what you can afford and you still try to catch up with them. Don't. Change your friend circle, right? Everybody, all friends need not have the same spending capacity. Maybe both of you have the same earning capacity, but he has a rich father and he does not have to pay any money at home. So he is able to save much, he is able to invest more also, but he is also able to spend more. Maybe he comes from a class of society where they think that a vacation means traveling only by air and only by J class, and only staying in 5-star hotels or at least 4-star plus kind of hotels. Don't fall into those traps of friend spending, right? That puts you into debt sometimes, right? So don't do that. Have your, your vacation or your fun or your car or everything can be budgeted. So when you budget that, you don't need to get into debt to do those things. Postpone your new car by 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, whatever. If you have to borrow money to buy a car, don't borrow money to buy, or you're borrowing an insignificant amount. It's a 10 lakh rupee car and you're borrowing 1 lakh of rupees. That's fine. But you don't borrow 9 lakhs for a 10 lakh rupee car, right? Don't do that. You don't have to be worried about what people think about you. That's our huge ego, which tells us you have to be worried about what others think about you. I actually don't even know my neighbor's name. I just know where he works. I've spoken to him, to his wife once or twice. They stayed here for 3-4 years and then they quit and they migrated out, right? So it is, they don't even know who you are. So how will they even care as to what you are wearing and what car you drive? Nobody is bothered about it. So don't get into that thing that if I don't get it now, I will be very unhappy. That's fine. Be unhappy. Teach your muscles to wait, right? Lot of people feel that if they surrender their debt, then their lifestyle will be compromised. If lifestyle is to be compromised, then do it. Because how will you get... how will you create your emergency fund if you're in debt, right? So getting out of debt should be your topmost priority, immaterial of what people tell you. You should not even be investing if you're in debt in other than the home mortgage. Just repay all the debt. That's the greatest investment you can do, right? Make sure that you and your spouse are agreeing upon this, and so that because it shouldn't happen that you are trying to save money to repay loans and she is spending money on something and she doesn't even know about what you're doing. So communicate, communicate, communicate. do that and make sure that you are completely within control of your debt. Stop saying lies to yourself. Thank you.